There's one massive study that changed everything about how we understand blood pressure. In fact, it was so influential that it was stopped early. It's also changed my perspective on blood pressure in even more drastic ways, which I'll also explain. You see, in the past, blood pressure recommendations were set to 140 over 90. That's the systolic and diastolic numbers on a blood pressure reading. These numbers correspond to the maximum pressure in your artery, so systolic, and the minimum pressure as the heart relaxes, so diastolic. Then a study released that completely obliterated the idea of 140 over 90. That's this study. In this study, the researchers randomly assigned over 9,000 cardiovascular disease at-risk people to one of two groups, a standard blood pressure lowering treatment or an intensive blood pressure lowering treatment. The difference between the two groups was the amount of medication given. The only distinguishing factor between the groups was to achieve less than 140 units for systolic blood pressure in those on the standard treatment, and to achieve around 120 units for systolic in those in the intensive treatment. We can see that they achieved that over several years. The standard treatment, as indicated by the vertical axis, maintained blood pressure under 140, and the intensive treatment maintained blood pressure around 120. So, what happened? If we look at the data, we see both treatments, standard in blue and the intensive in orange. The higher the lines go, the more cardiovascular events like heart attack, stroke, heart failure, and death occur. You can see that at the 1 year mark, well, there's no difference. Yet, even one more year later, and definitely 3 years later, the results are clear. The intensive treatment condition were at a much lower risk, about 25% lower than the standard treatment condition. In fact, the evidence was so clear the researchers had to stop the study early because it's unethical to continue when the evidence strongly indicates intensive treatment should be offered to the other group. So, since then, blood pressure recommendations have been reduced to 120 over 80. Technically getting under that. And that's where I think more emphasis needs to be made. Because as far as I'm aware, it's not like we know that 120 over 80 is the end all be all. We know it's better than a higher blood pressure, but we don't know if it's just it as, I don't know, 100 over 60, for example. And my two cents is that the lower you can get your blood pressure, the better. Now, before someone with very low blood pressure starts slambasting me about their struggles, I'm talking about cardiovascular disease. It's true that too low of blood pressure can cause their own issues, which we'll get into, because the results of this study were not all rosy. There were downsides. However, on a cardiovascular health front, it seems reasonable to me that the lowest a person's blood pressure can be, with a key emphasis on while still being able to function normally, the better. There are points at which low blood pressure can be a problem, and the researchers outline a few problems that participants experienced on this intensive treatment. There's some finer details of this study that I'll be going over in my research review that I wrote for the Physionic Insiders. If you're so inclined to learn more, you can join through the link in the description. You also get access to all my work along with a monthly podcast distilling everything down for you and a premium email list so that I send you all the most important actionable information. Okay, enough marketing. So, there's this table, and don't let your eyes glaze over. I'm only going to highlight a few things here. As a quick reference, if these numbers on the far right under p-value are less than 0.05, it indicates a statistically significant effect, or in less statistics terms, there's a likely effect happening between the groups. Now, I'll bring your attention to hypotension and syncope. They're related. Essentially, passing out and overly low blood pressure was experienced by some people in the intensive treatment group at a higher rate than those in the standard treatment. However, if I point out one more thing, acute kidney injury was also more frequent in the intensive treatment group, about 70% increased. So, why might all this be? Well, the low blood pressure and passing out makes sense simply because that's the nature of artificially reducing blood pressure through drugs. However, the kidney damage is explained by the researchers as one of two things. Well, one, some blood pressure medications are diuretics. They flush water out of the body, as well as drugs that directly affect the kidneys, like angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors. We don't need to get into the details other than some drugs directly target the kidneys. These drugs could have temporarily affected kidney function. The second explanation is due to low blood pressure, the kidneys receiving less blood, called perfusion, which could also cause kidney damage. So, where does that leave us? Confused? Concerned? Well, let's address it. This indicates that possibly kidney-specific blood pressure medications should be avoided. More specifically, if you're compounding multiple medications for blood pressure, since the intensive group was taking three. And if you look at the supplemental data, over 1,000 people were on four or more medications. So one might still be good to go, but as you add more, the risk may increase. We also don't know if this applies to all blood pressure medications or just kidney-specific ones. I wish that the researchers had done a subgroup analysis to tease out some of those specifics. Alas, they did not. So, what are the key takeaways here? The main point of this study is that reducing your blood pressure to less than 120 over 80 is a huge benefit to your cardiovascular health. However, as it seems to also be indicated by this study, trying to do that without blood pressure medication that affects the kidneys is preferable, and being on many blood pressure medications may cause harm to the kidneys, an area that still needs to be investigated more. So, how does one reduce their blood pressure then? Well, if you're interested in the easiest exercise that has a potent effect, check this out. And if you're interested in taking a supplement or adding some things to your diet instead, check this out. I'll see you over there.